Hello and welcome to this Warcry Catacombs painting video. In this video, we're going to be showing how to paint some of the dungeon terrain that's featured in this box set. Now, by following the colours and methods in this video, you'll be able to easily paint the majority of the dungeon terrain. For some of the other terrain, like the ruins, just check out our other video on how to paint Warcry terrain. So the first thing we need to do before we begin painting is undercoat the model. And as you can see here, I've undercoated the sewer vent with Mechanica Standard Grey, which is perfect for the colours we're applying. Now I'm going to start off by using Snakebite Leather. I'm going to apply this straight over that undercoat. It's going to give it a nice stone effect. So I'll be using a medium shade brush for this. I'm just going to load up my brush, put some on the palette just so I don't like splodge it anywhere else. So I'm loading up that brush, and then all we're going to do is start painting over that masonry. So all we're going to do is just start applying this all over that masonry like so. You want to do quite a thick coat, and just give it a good time to dry. So you're probably looking about an hour for it to dry. There we are with that Snakebite Leather now thoroughly dry. What we're going to do now is move on to highlighting that stonework. Now we're doing dry brushes here. We're going to start with Carrick Stone as our first dry brush and just finish off with a little bit of Screaming Skull. But first of all, let's start with the Carrick Stone. So I'm using a medium dry brush here. Let's load up my brush a little bit. Whenever doing any dry brushing, it's always worth just doing some circular motions, crisscrossing. What you're aiming to do here is remove a lot of that extra bit of paint that's embedded itself into the middle of those bristles, but also to remove as much of that pigment as possible. Once I'm happy, which I am, and then ready to start going up and down on the actual texture of this stonework. Now, when you're doing dry brushing, obviously you want to go with the flow, so against the grain, if you like. So if you've got like a little gap down here, if you go up and down like that, it's going to go into the recesses, so you need to go side by side. So just keep moving your brush around to go with the flow of actually where the details are, avoiding trying to get that dry brush into the details. There we are with that first dry brush done. What we're going to do now is do our next dry brush and final dry brush on this stonework, which is to use a little bit of Screaming Skull. Now we're just gently tickling this, so hardly touching it, as we're just going around some of those definitive edges on the top here and down. And also when you get to things like skulls and stuff, you can always put a bit more pressure on, just add a bit more definition to the skulls if you need to. There we are with all that stonework now dry brushed and highlighted. What we're going to do now is move on to the next area, which is the metal grating on the top. Follow this guide also for any of the metals that are going to be on your bits of scenery. So we're going to start with Iron Warriors as a base coat. We're then going to shade all over with Agraxo shade. Then we're going to use a little bit of Griffhound Orange and just drop this into the recesses and cracks. It will drive a bit of an orangey stain to it, so it looks a bit rusty. And then we'll finish off with a dry brush of Stormhost Silver. But first of all, let's start with that base coat. So what I'm going to do here is just use my medium base brush. Apply a little bit of Iron Warriors to the palette, a little bit of water, so there's not too much resistance. I'll add a little bit more to that, that's better. And then all we're going to do is then just start base coating that grate. Try and avoid getting some on the actual stonework. And what you could do if you really wanted to is, because there's some paint just on these bits here, is you don't have to go all the way to the edge, because the Agraxo shade, which is the next stage, can do a lot of that work for you anyway. With the metal now base coated, what we're going to do now is use Agraxo shade just to coat all over that. So make sure you cover all those bits, even in the nooks and crannies down here as well. You can also use this opportunity to just apply a little bit of the Agraxo shade over some of those skulls you dry brushed over as well. Just add a little bit of difference from the actual Snakebite Leather that's in the base coats of those. With the Agraxo shade now dry, what we're going to do now is get a little bit of Griffhound Orange, drop it into some of the cracks and around those rivets. When it dries, it will give it a bit more of a rusty kind of feel. Don't think too much about this. Try not to be like too neat or precise, because you actually want the rust to feel a little bit more natural. There we are with the Griffhound Orange dry. What we're going to do now is just finish off the metalwork with a nice little soft dry brush of Stormhost Silver. Again, just picking out those raised areas like the rivets, these little locks and clasps. There we are with that dry brush done, our sewer grate is finished. So what we're going to do now is move on to our next piece of scenery, which is an archway. Now we're going to be doing the black and jade colour scheme that you see on the box art. For this, we're going to start with the base coats first. So for the jade areas, we'll use Incubi Darkness. And for the black areas when we base coat, we'll use Abaddon Black. Then with dry brushes as our highlights, we're going to start with Cabalite Green for the jade, followed by Saberite Green. And then for the black, we'll use Thunderhawk Blue, followed by Fenrisian Grey. But first of all, let's start our base coats. So like I said, for that jade colour scheme, we're going to start with Incubi Darkness. So I'm going to get a couple of dollops, a little bit of water. In fact, if you do over thin this, it's not the end of the world, because some of that Mechanica Standard Grey shown through will actually give you a nice little subtle highlight anyway. So what we're going to be doing here is picking out these columns with all the skulls on and the interior texture that follows around this archway. So if you want to just add a couple of coats, you're more than welcome. Just work your way around. There we are, with the Incubi Darkness now base coated. What I'm going to do now is use a Baden Black for the rest of those black stone areas. Again, just thin that down slightly and just work your way around. If you make any splodges like I've just done just here, just tidy back up with Incubi Darkness. There we are, those black details now base coated. What we're going to now do is start dry brushing those jade areas. For this, I'm going to be using Cabalite Green. I want to do a couple of coats of this just to build up that actual layer, make it nice and strong. I'm also using a medium base brush here because it's a little bit smaller and it's a battered old brush. So I'm actually okay using this for dry brushing. With that first dry brush done, we're now going to use Saberite Green as our last highlight on the jade areas. Just going to keep it more into the central areas so you've got a bit of a blend going on, so a bit darker to lighter. Do that on both sides and then just do these bits on the top here. There we are with the jade stone done. We're now going to concentrate on the black stone, and for this we're going to start our first dry brush of Thunderhawk Blue. So just back and forth like so, picking out those raised edges. There we are with the first dry brush done. We're going to finish off the black stone with Fenrisian Grey. Again, just a softer dry brush here, just picking out some of those raised areas like the rivets, details on the skull, etc. With that dry brush done, our black stone is finished. So what we're going to do now is move on to some red stone, which is also featured quite a lot on some of the scenery. We're using a different archway for this. Now we're going to start off with a base coat of Galvorbat Red, we're going to dry brush with Corn Red, and then finish off with a dry brush of Wazdaka Red. But first of all, let's start with that base coat. So I'm just going to load my brush up, get a couple of dollops onto the palette, a little bit of water. And again, I'm using my medium base brush for this. So all we're going to do is start picking out this skull detail that's just on this archway here. You might want to do a couple of thin coats of this, just to make sure you get a nice even coverage. There we are with the redstone now base coated. We're going to dry brush with Corn Red. Again, just slowly picking out those edges, building up that layer. So you might have to do this a couple of times just to get a bit more strength to it. Take your time. There we are with our first dry brush done. We're now going to finish off with a bit of Wazdaka Red. There we are, that dry brush done, our redstone is finished. So what we're going to do now is we're going to move on to doing some teal stone. And for this, we're using another archway for this example. So what we're going to start off with is Incubi Darkness as a base coat. We're then going to dry brush with Sotek Green and then finish off with a final dry brush of Temple Guard Blue. First of all, let's start with that base coat. I'm just going to get a couple of dollops again, get more water, and then we're ready to start painting. So we've got a large skull area here to do. So you might again want to do a couple of coats of Incubi Darkness just to build up the strength of that actual tone. With the skull now base coated in Incubi Darkness, we're now going to start doing our first dry brush of Sotek Green. So again, just slowly build up those layers, go back down and get some more paint if you need to. Again, back and forth, trying to avoid getting into the recesses if you can. With our first dry brush completed, we're now going to use Temple Guard Blue just to finish that teal stone off. Again, just really gentle with this one, so you're just picking out some of those raised areas, nice and soft like. And there we are, by combining all these different methods and colours in this video, you too can finish your Warcry scenery that comes in the Catacombs box set. Now there's a couple of things to remember when painting these models. Firstly, when doing dry brushing, just build up those layers slowly and try and remove as much pigment from the bristles as possible. Also, when using shades and contrast, try not to overload your brush too much as it can quickly run out of control. If you do find that happening, just use your brush to soak up any excess. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoy painting your own Warcry dungeon terrain, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.